I'm J.M. Baum, full professor in the 3D design areas of the Department of Art and Design, and the director of the Object Lab, a rapid technologies and digital fabrication lab. The focus of my research is a suite of technologies known as rapid technologies and digital fabrication, which includes laser scanning and imaging, 3D computer modeling, laser cutting, CNC milling, and 3D printing. This suite of technologies captured my attention when I saw how it was revolutionizing the way we made things, our physical world, and revolutionizing the design of the things that we made. The technology has applications in many, if not all, industries and disciplines, from aerospace and defense, to various medical fields, to all kinds of consumer products, and to all kinds of art and culture. The 3D printing process begins in one of two ways, by digitizing an existing object with a tool such as a laser scanner, or building the object in specialized computer-aided design software. Once we have a digital version of the object, it can be produced in any number of ways with a whole range of digital fabrication processes and equipment. 3D printing seems to be the most captivating of the suite of technologies today because it still seems like science fiction to us. 3D printing is also known as additive manufacturing because it creates objects by building them layer by layer. The technology is akin to inkjet printing, but instead of laying down ink line by line, we're laying down physical material, very fine layer by very fine layer, building up an object. There's a number of 3D printing technologies out there today: fused deposition modeling, powder bed fusion, and laser sintering. And today we can print on the upwards of 30 to 40 different materials, from plaster to plastics to metals. This technology is a game changer in a number of ways. We can create complex geometry in a single piece that would otherwise be difficult to create. So if we can imagine it and we can model it, we can make it.